Let's talk about the sensitive period for movement. This period lasts from birth to about the age of 4. It is so important because human beings have a natural need to explore. And without movement, there's no way that we would be able to satisfy that need. Our infants are born with no voluntary movement. They may have some reflex actions, but really no voluntary movement, even over their eyes. It takes time and a process called the myelin sheathing to develop down the spine. And as it develops down the spine, corresponding movement can occur. So we have an infant that is essentially inert, and in only a couple of years becomes a master of their own body that can run and skip and jump and dance. There are two distinct types of movement that Dr. Montessori identified in our development. The first is the development of equilibrium for locomotion, and the second is the development of the hand. Let's start with the development of equilibrium. This is much like the development of language in the sense that in order to create language, you have to hear language. And in order to develop movement, you have to see movement. This is why the sensitive period begins at birth, because the child has to have time to observe people moving around them before they can ever animate their own body. The child is driven to achieve equilibrium, and all children, regardless of gender or race, reach these movement milestones at approximately the same time. And this is due because of the observation that the child had done and that process I mentioned before of myelin sheathing, which begins at the base of the skull and moves its way down the spine. This is why we see movement for babies first begin in the eyes and the head, and then later down their trunk. So first, the child gains control over their head. And then as that process of myelin sheathing moves down the spine, the child is able to push up. So they've got control over arms. Later, they're able to sit, and then they're able to stand, and around 12 months, they can walk. Walking is the crowning achievement of the child because now their hands are free. Their feet can take them where they want to go, and their hands can do the work that they're looking for. This is easily seen if you have ever been around a child that's learning how to walk. They take a couple steps and then down they go. They take another step or two and down they go again. And they repeat and repeat and repeat. This repetition is helping to build the muscle memory that they need to gain equilibrium. When the child reaches about 18 months of age, so toddler age, we see them demonstrating something called maximum effort. Maximum effort is when you see these small children carrying very heavy things, or they're pushing the chairs around the living room, or crawling up and down the stairs. My daughter was a stair climber, and she would do it every single night, up and down, up and down, up and down. Of course, I stay close, but to interrupt her, she would have melted down into a great fit. The reason for that is because the repetition was helping her satisfy this sensitive period, helping her build the skill that she needed to be able to get up and down those stairs with confidence. Sometimes, as adults, we have to step back and let the repetition happen because we understand there's something greater at work there. This sensitive period was very strong for my daughter at that time. The development of the hand parallels the development of equilibrium and is equally important because while the feet can take us where we want to go, it's our hands that are doing the manipulation that's going to grow the intelligence. In the first 6 months of life, the child is discovering their hands. They start to reach and grasp, and then there is a first intentional grasp, that grasp with purpose. When the child reaches 12 months old, now we have a walker with free hands. This is a level of independence that the child has never seen. Not only can they move to where they want to go, but their hands can do all of the manipulating that they need them to do. as a parent or as an adult, we're looking for milestones for our children in their movement. And typically the milestones that we're searching for are the ones of the baby rolling over or sitting up or taking those first steps. We're never looking at the hands, and the hands are so important, and they go through stages of their own in the different kinds of grasps that the child is able to master. And over time, that movement becomes more practiced and more refined. The child learns that those hands have strength and that those hands can be quite soft too. Dr. Montessori says that the hands are so delicate and complicated that they allow us to reveal our intelligence, but they also allow us to create a relationship with the world around us. Well-meaning adults get in the way of this sensitive period. How many of us put locks on our cabinets and our cupboards and put gates across hallways before we brought a baby home? How many of us may have used a crib or a playpen to keep the baby safe, maybe when we walked out of the room? All of these things get in the way of a child being able to act and move freely in their environment. Is it so bad that the child gets into the cupboard and takes out all of the Tupperware? Yes, it's a huge mess, but what that child is actually gaining from that experience is something that we really can't begin to understand, because something is motivating that activity, and every activity that a child engages in is satisfying something developmentally for them. How often do we put fragile objects up and away from the child? We don't want the objects to be broken or perhaps the child to be harmed if the object fell. But the fact is that children can be very careful with fragile things. They just need to be shown how to hold them. And that's something many adults don't think about, is that a child can be quite careful, but we have to give them the lesson on how to do that. The Montessori Children's House is the perfect place for a child to be passing through this sensitive period, because there are many outlets for them to be refining their movement. Every single exercise in the environment provides an opportunity to refine the body, the hands, the equilibrium. The child can sit anywhere they want. They can sit on the floor, which is often most comfortable for the child, or they can sit at a table. It's completely up to them. In the classroom, we reinforce that the children take items one at a time. And the reason we do this is that it offers them an opportunity to practice this equilibrium, to practice control over their body. And in the same breath, we have sensorial materials that have 10 pieces to the whole. And this means if the child's taking one at a time, they'll be making 10 trips to the shelf and 10 trips back to take and put the material away. This offers a lot of great experience for the child to be practicing and refining the control of their body and their balance. We also have walking on the line, and walking on the line is an exercise that is designed just for the refinement of equilibrium. And there are several levels to walking on the line so that it remains an inviting challenge to every child in the classroom. What's beautiful about walking on the line is that it's available all day long, so a child can get on the line and off the line whenever they feel the need. And then most fun, in my opinion, is something called the silence game. The silence game is the only exercise in the classroom that requires no movement. But how can that support the development and refinement of movement? Well, the goal of the exercise is to quiet the body, to refrain from moving. This restraint requires the ultimate control over the body. This is an invitation to the child's will that is hard for them to resist. The Children's House is an incredible place for a child to be passing through this sensitive period for movement. There are so many opportunities for them to practice in various ways and to refine and grow.